The first of two meetings between the Red Wings and the Oilers. And the first shot is a goal, and it is Drake Kajula. He continues to hold the hot hand, and the Oilers have a 1-0 lead.
Wow. What a start for the Edmonton Oilers. Remember last time they were in here in this building, they scored 6 goals. Connor McDavid, so quick, gets on the forecheck quickly, comes underneath the stick, and then upstairs to Dylan Larkin's shot. Look at how he lifts the stick off of Dylan Larkin, and then right to Drake Kajula, who wasted no time on the stick, off the stick. But the key is the speed of the forecheck by Connor McDavid.
November 1st. Oh, you're more.
3 weeks in. Look out here.
Here's Rasmussen. That was blocked, another shot. From a guy 6'6 on a guy 6'7. Hey. Scores! De La Rose! His first as a Red Wing. Ties the game. 1-1. Jacob De La Rose.
Moral of the story here is don't give up, boy. Kulaski decides to pinch in, keeps it in. Will he get an assist? It's 27. It's 14. No, he won't. Too bad. But 27 and 14 probably will. Good wrist shot by the big guy. Loose puck. Backhander right there to De La Rose, and he's squeezing it in the short side. The goaltender won't like that. The coach won't like it. But good perseverance by the Red Wings to tie this game. A bad bounce there on the goaltender.
Nugent Hopkins hustles to get to it. Gets it to Larson, across to McDavid. McDavid. Chiasson scores. Alex Chiasson puts home his 6th goal of the season. And the Oilers retake the lead. 1:15 into the period. The Oilers strike.
It starts with good forecheck by McDavid's line. There's the chop by Trevor Daley on the legs of Ryan Nugent-Hopkins. The extended power play now kicks into gear. And what happens is Connor McDavid moves to find the seam. Look at the work that happens, though, by Ryan Nugent-Hopkins. Keep the puck alive. Adam Larson, now here's the seam pass. Beautifully done by Connor McDavid. That's actually 2 seam passes, one by Adam Larson, and then McDavid, looking one way, passes it the other. Beautiful. Percentage is dropping.
Uh-oh. Here's a giveaway. Brontiac shot, scores! Kyle Brontiac, his first goal this season, and the Oilers have a 3-1 lead. The hard work of the fourth line pays off.
And we've seen it all night. They've been on their toes, they've been after the puck, they've hunted the puck in the offensive zone, they've created chances and offensive zone time. Drew Jarkera going to work inside, going to keep going after, puts the chase on. Good job by Zach Cassian to come in and force a bad pass. Kara's there to support, and Kyle Brodziak, good third man high. Lay it out to him, get the shot on your stick and off your stick in a hurry. Terrific job by this fourth line to get the Oilers a goal, but it's all because of hard work, hunting the puck and making smart, high percentage plays. Kyle Brodziak, big smile, his first goal in 26 games versus an Oiler.
Glendening trying to work toward the goal. Back to the line, and a shot by DeKaiser. Oh. It's goal!
Oh my gosh, how'd that get in? Could it be Megan? What a weird goal. Credit Luke Glendening. I don't know if you're getting assist on this or not. Just tenacious work by Glendening, pulling up, going back to the point. What does it hit? Hit the blocker, hit his skate. This is going to be the defenseman's goal from the point. Hit his own skate. He looked over his left shoulder, pulled his right foot off the goal post and knocked it in with his own skate. Look at this. Oh my goodness. Wow.
On the faceoff, Jarkera to Brodziak. Brodziak hangs on, lets a shot go, and he scores. Kyle Brodziak, his 2nd goal of the game, and the Oilers have opened up a 4-2 lead.
Big smiles. Look at everybody so happy. That's what happens when the hardworking guys get the goals. The fourth line guys score, everybody gets happy. Now this is really terrific. Brodziak wins the draw. Look at the work by Jujar here. Gets in, protects the puck. Jack Cassian creates the space, and that allows Kyle Brodziak to walk in. All three guys involved. Puck protection, finds your man. Zach Cassian pushes a man out of the way, provides the ocular distraction for the goaltender, and Kyle Brodziak makes no mistake. Upstairs it goes, and the Oilers take another two goals.
Daly able to stop Nugent Hopkins. Larkin back to Nyquist. Back to Larkin, the shot. Loose in front. Down another there. Scores Bertuzzi!
Minute 26. Now they're going to challenge. They're calling for a high stick. I can see that already. Todd McClellan on their bench. Larkin lets that shot go. It's up in the air. Oh, that's way below, I'm thinking. Yeah. Well, they'll be looking at it for sure. I think it looks like it's below the bar, at least on that replay for Bertuzzi. It came down. Took a long time to come down. Yeah, that looks pretty legal. This angle might be the best one we've got. Where does he make contact? No question about it.
It's way legal.
No question about it.
No. Yep. Red Wings have called timeout.
It'll be an easy call to make for the room. So Bertuzzi pops another one.